All right, guys, this is Gwyn. With me is Mr. Llama. We're here with Group C on Saturday. Group C, of course, with AZiO, State, Golden, and Todd in it. It's going to be fantastic. We have our first match of the day, Llama. Who's it going to be?
Our first match of the day is going to be between AZiO. He is going to be playing as Neuromod, and QuanticState, who's going to be playing as STRA.
Yep.
So they got their own little accounts right there, their American accounts, but... should be a great game.
Yep. Jumping on into a little bit of a PvP action coming on ESV Cloud Kingdom. That will be our starting map for the day. Gonna jump straight on in. I'm pretty excited about this.
I'm extremely excited.
You know, AZiO is a player I haven't seen play. Literally at all.
No, and he used to be on Team Prime, actually.
Yeah, he did.
So, not sure why he left, but we're gonna get right on into it. Down in the bottom left corner, are going to have QuanticState, the red Protoss,
yep.
And spawning up in the top right is Neuromod, aka AZiO, from Team ESC Icy Bucks.
Yep, and we do have both of them spawning in, making those probes. And I mean, this is a map that there's actually a lot you can do on.
Right.
The oh, We're going to have a pause. Oh, no. Oh, no. State.
A pause to set the hotkeys. I have never seen a pause for setting hotkeys.
Maybe his hotkeys were on grid, and he doesn't play grid.
Possible. I'm going to go ahead and assume that that's the reason, instead of him just copy-paste. Sure. But yeah, I'm going to go ahead and assume that this pause is the hotkey setup layout is not...
Yep. Not set correctly. That's got to be it.
That makes it feel a little bit better than, oh, wait, I forgot to hotkey my Nexus.
Yeah, that... You can't actually set those hotkeys.
No.
While you're paused.
No, you cannot. So both.
But players start state now actually the gets. Pylon yeah, he gets. It. State missed his pylon there. Probably because he messed up his hotkeys. So AZiO is gonna have a lead, and in a PvP, Mr. Llama, that's actually a big deal. To be that behind.
In any mirror matchup, that's a big deal.
State is 10-gating.
State's 10-gating. Wow.
So maybe he didn't miss that pylon.
That was an intentional late pylon, and I feel bad for calling him out now on it.
So do I. I think even if you're 10-gating, though, you're still supposed to pylon
drop a 9.
Yeah.
I feel like that makes sense. But you know what? He dropped it down on 10, and maybe he decided to change his build up right there. You never know.
It's possible. It's possible. He is checking out around inside his base, and that's really important to do on this map, especially. What I was going to say before we got interrupted by that pause is that the main here is actually really big, and that means you can hide buildings, you can hide cannons, things like that in your opponent's base. Even at a pro level, I've definitely seen it done. There's a particular player, Gosu Rhythm, who has like a beautiful cannon rush on this map. It's literally like one of the most beautiful things I've ever seen. He cannon rushes from two sides at the same time, and he shows you one of them. And then you're so busy dealing with the one, you don't notice that the other side of your base also has cannons.
And something that I've always noticed is also behind those mineral patches there, you have that the four mineral patches all lined up, and I've seen players so many times block themselves in with pylons there and just go for that cannon
go
rush.
Go the manor pylon?
Yeah. Yep.
Just like in Brood War, man. Manor pylon.
Manor pylons.
But I want to point out, look at how much ahead the core is for State. And he's already making his first stalker, and granted, the stalker's not going to be out in time to deny the scout out of AZiO, but this is a really fast stalker.
And it's not like Daisy's going to be able to see exactly the progress or anything like that on the Cybernex core. So he's going to get in, he's going to see a Cybernex core, a gateway, and he doesn't really know if that came down as a 10 gate, as whatever it is. The only thing is that the Zealot, I suppose, was out a little bit faster, but even then.
Well, he knows. I mean, with this Stalker popping out like this, he has to know that the core is greatly accelerated. And also, AZiO is a smart player. He's going to be counting those probes, and if we go to the probe count, you can see that State is two probes behind, which is pretty significant at this point. So, a really aggressive opening out of State. He is going to have to make something happen with this if he wants to make it pay off. And I think he's actually just going to go 3-gate Stalker with this, adding on the two additional gates.
And we have 2-gate Stalker coming out here, which is such a strong opening
standard
by AZiO. Very, very strong. And we'll have to see if he'll be able to hold this, though. If he can snipe that probe, though, that would be huge. And that would completely set State in a terrible position.
State, though, boldly throwing the pylon on the low ground. He's coming up to throw the one on the high ground as well. If you get two pylons up like this, it's actually such a hard position to be in. State microing his Zealot very, very well, but two more stalkers are about to pop up. State has to clear out. He does at just the last moment, but he has another stalker.
For both players here, so... Yep. Warping down on the low ground, just going to be an additional stalker. Two more stalkers being warped in right here. And it looks like...
Oh! Probe's getting pulled, and I think that AZiO actually should stabilize after this, especially with the probe pull.
He also has the four stalkers there. Yep. So he's just going to slowly pick away at these pylons right here, and just continue to pick away at the stalkers as well. The Zealot's going to go down before even warping in. Barely makes it out there alive. The good news is he's able to at least kill off a few probes, but he's behind already five probes, so this probe pool doesn't matter too much right here.
Yeah, he definitely has to kill probes, and he loses his high ground pylon, which is his sight to the high ground, his ability to warp in up there, and his sight for attacking. So he gets sight once again, warps the stalker up the high ground, but man, State is just losing all of his stalkers right here, and he's in a really tough position. He has started making probes again, but did he do enough damage? The probe count is actually equal now, so maybe State was able to put enough hurt on. He is going to be woefully behind in tech, though. Look at the gas bank that we do have out of
Daisy.
And
he's also behind an army, if you look at that as well. So definitely not in the best positions right here for State. Good news is at least he's ahead in the probe count just a little bit. So that's going to help him a tiny bit. And it looks like he's transitioning into possibly Blink Stalker with this Twilight Council.
Oh, and State kills off the probe that was building the pylon. But does he see the pylon? He does, but he misses it. Oh, no. He lets a proxy pylon get up on his side of the map. That's going to be tough. Maybe he saw it and he decided not to kill it. I don't know. That feels like a strange decision to me, but here we go.
I think he just knew that Daisy was going to be moving out across the map there, and he wouldn't really have enough. So he's going to try and defend this ramp here, but he doesn't really have too many units. Forcefield does go down at the bottom there, so that's going to force these stalkers back a little bit. He can get around to warp-ins right here, at least a couple more stalkers, if he wishes. But it looks like he's just going to chill on this contain, possibly.
Yep. And, I mean, it's correct for Daisy to just sort of put this pressure on his opponent. Look what he did. Right. He forced another sentry out of State. And State, I mean, right now he's adding on that Twilight Council. You know, he probably wants Blink or he wants DTs. No, there is the Blink coming out of State. So he wants to be spending his money on things like that. But he had to delay getting that Blink up because he had to warp the second sentry in.
Great play. Notice as well, though, from Daisy, two sentries back home. So interesting right there. What do you think the reasoning is behind that?
Well, I mean, he's teching really hard, right? He only has the two gates out on the map, so he was pressuring with those stalkers, and he gets the robo out as well. And the robo's a big investment, so you kind of have to cover yourself in that sort of situation. You can't allow your opponent to get in a position where they can counterattack you with a proxy pylon or something that you didn't see and move out. But here we go. We have the Colossus Den on the way, as I like to call it, Robotics Bay, and a Warp Prism actually out for Daisy, so we're going to see a little bit of Warp Prism harass with those two Zealots moving out along the right-hand side of the map.
But now we see that State's moving out across the map as well, and he's starting to grow a sizable army right there, and if he can catch Daisy right here before he gets out anything. He's also going to have Blink, so he can Blink straight up on top of that army.
He's actually going for Warp Prism speed, not for Colossus out of that Robotics Bay, so this is actually really, really cool out of Daisy. I'm super happy that we're seeing just something completely unorthodox. State peppering the map with pylons on Daisy's side, and he's moving forward. He has Blink finished. And yeah, I mean, this is one of those situations where if State can sort of hit a timing where he can get in and do a lot of damage to the low gateway count, he can do a lot. But here comes that Warp Prism as well. It's going to have Warp Prism speed soon, and this is going to be so hard for State to deal with back home.
And he's revealed his Blink right here, but this is just going to be so difficult for Daisy right now. As you can see, he's got a lot of stalkers. Will that second mortal get out? Yes, it will. So now with two mortals, he can feel a little bit safer in this engagement, and we're going to see State back out. In the meantime, the Zealot's doing so much damage back home. Seven kills there?
Yep. And the Warp Prism does pick up and just retreat. And that Warp Prism is so fast. With that upgrade. It's literally kind of silly. But State, with those Blink Stalkers, actually has a perfect response to that, even though he didn't know that was going to be the good response, right? So, you know, really, really, lucky for State there, kind of, that he was able to, have a good response to that Speed Warp Prism play. And I feel like maybe this is one of the weaknesses of that Speed Warp Prism play in this matchup. It's just that you can very easily run into situations where it's like, well, you know, my Speed Warp Prism just got Blunk. Just got Blunk, man.
Yeah. No, you definitely can. This is definitely a tricky one. But it looks like I would like to see some sort of expand off of a push here from Neuromod, or from Daisy, I should say. But it looks like he's just going to be pumping out these
Colossus. He's adding the fourth gate, man. This is four-gate Colossus all in off one base.
Four-gate Colossus Robo. Yeah, four-gate Robo all in on one base. And he's got the three Immortals, so that's going to be huge in the Blink Stalker fight.
Yep.
That's just such a great counter. Immortals are so good against Stalkers.
Yep. And I mean, the Immortal count is high enough to where you can't really be cost effective. And the other problem is,
exactly,
with these threes.